हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? फिट एंड फाइन? नाउ टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट अवर नेक्स्ट लेसन, दैट इज हाउ डू ऑर्गेनिजम्स रिप्रोड्यूस. हाउ दिस मींस हाउ दे रिप्रोड्यूस, दिस मींस दिस लेसन इज रिलेटेड टू रिप्रोडक्शन. बी रेडी विद ए पेन एंड नोटबुक टू नोट डाउन द इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स while attending this online class for the production. Now, you will see that how the organisms reproduce. First of all, why they reproduce? All the living organisms, they reproduce to increase their number or to increase their population. Now, what is reproduction? Reproduction is the process by which organisms produce young ones of its own kind for the continuity of their race. We all know that all living organisms, including human beings, we are all not immortal. We are mortal. It means everyone who is born that will die one day. And to replace these dead animals by the young ones, all living organisms, they reproduce. Now, what is the need of reproduction? Reproduction is also a life process. Life processes we have done: nutrition, respiration, transportation, excretion, etc. And we all know that without these life processes, organisms cannot survive. But that organism which is not reproducing, that can also survive. So reproduction is not necessary for the survival of a particular organism or for the individual, but it is necessary for the continuation of race or for perpetuation. Now, what is the need of reproduction? Reproduction is necessary for continuation of life. Reproduction is the only way by which living organisms, they produce young ones of their own kind. Because the pre-existing organism, they produce the next generation or next organism. So for the continuity of life on this earth, reproduction is necessary. Because if living organism they will not reproduce, then one day it will come that older ones they keep on dying and no new one is producing, then one day will come when there will not be any life on this earth. So for the continuation of life on the earth, reproduction is very necessary. Next, regeneration of species. You will see that these species, they are continued for millions of years. The same organism that produces young ones of its own kind, if producing, then it gives the birth to pup. Cat gives birth to kittens, but as they grow up, they will be similar to their parents. So preservation of species, that is also possible due to reproduction. Next, replacement of dead individuals. As the living organisms, they keep on dying after completing their life, then these dead animals, they are replaced by the new ones which born by the parents. that it brings some change. You will see that we are similar to our parents, but in some respect we are different from them also. So this difference, either among the brothers, sisters, or either from the parents, this is called variation. And this variation, each individual, this variation gives the individuality to a particular organism. We can identify the different organism from each other. We can differentiate them from other organism. How? Due to its individuality, due to changes, or due to some particular characteristics which are present only in that particular organism. So these variations, when keep on accumulating generation to generation, at a specific level they are in very small amount or very little changes that appear. But as the generation goes on, from one generation to other or other to the next, then these variations, they keep on accumulating and help in forming a new species, that is called evolution. So this is role of evolution. They help in, they play an important role in evolution, or they help in bringing evolution to form the new species. Now, means of hereditary transmission. How the reproduction takes place, or how the hereditary characters, they transfer from one generation to another. We know that all living organisms, they are having certain characteristics, and these characteristics are present at the germ in the germ cells, and these germ cells, they form the blueprint of their own. These molecules, some macromolecules, are also present in living organism, and at the time of reproduction they form the blueprint of these characteristics. Same blueprint is formed, which is transmitted to the next generation by reproduction. How? Because during the reproduction gamete cells are formed. Two parents are required, male and female. So at the time of reproduction, this DNA or hereditary material, which is containing all these characters, that will be transferred to next generation and help in the transmission of these hereditary characteristics. Hereditary characteristics are the characteristics which are coming from the parents to the next generation. The information about different characteristics, that is already encoded in the DNA molecules, or in the form of sequence of nucleotide. Listen, DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid, this is the main segment or which is containing the genes. DNA ki structure kya hoti hai? Sabse pehle to hum DNA structure ka lete hain. Basic hota kya hai isme? Sugar molecules hota hai, one phosphate is attached to it, and having the nucleotide base, it is having the different bases. These bases are adenosine, guanine, thymine, and all these bases, they are in proper sequence. If the sequence of these are changed, then what will happen? The characteristic will change. For example, of a case, again a present in the form of, which are combination of DNA plus protein forming chromatin material. Now this chromatin material, when before the reproduction, this will condense and forming chromosome. DNA molecules, when they condense, before this they replicate also. What is DNA replication? DNA replication क्या होती है? DNA में होता क्या है? Chromosome molecules होते हैं, micro molecules. They will form the exact copies of it. एक DNA से उसकी exact copies और बनती है. इसी तरह हमारे बॉडी के अंदर, सेल के अंदर बहुत सारे DNA होते हैं और उससे उसकी कॉपीज बनती है. इस फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एक्जेक्ट कॉपीज ऑफ इट्स मॉलिक्यूल, दैट इज कॉल्ड DNA रेप्लिकेशन. एंड दिस DNA रेप्लिकेशन हेल्प इन ब्रिंगिंग द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक इन नेक्स्ट जनरेशन. DNA रेप्लिकेशन जब ये अपनी एक्जेक्ट कॉपीज बना रहा है, इट मीन सेम कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स आर गोइंग टू नेक्स्ट जनरेशन. But sometimes what happens during the metabolism or biochemical reactions, during this DNA replication, some mistakes or some error comes. So these mistakes or errors which come at the time of this replication, that brings some variations or changes. These variations due to change at the time of replication, these are called mutations. Mutations. These are called mutations. Now, variations in multicellular organism. This takes place in all organisms, either in unicellular or multicellular. In unicellular and organism also, the variations they are seen. Take the example of bacteria or this streptomycin resistant bacteria or susceptible to streptomycin. जो susceptible होती हैं, they are killed by the streptomycin. But which are resistant, they are not having any effect of streptomycin. Even in this presence, they grow up. So these bacteria which grow up in this presence, which are called streptomycin resistant bacteria. So in multicellular organisms, the chances of variation in the individuals of population can be due to some reason. कब कब हो सकती है? First of all, at the time of DNA replication, जो mutation होती है. ये कब होती है? At the time of DNA replication, due to error or change during the protein formation or during biochemical reaction. Next, variation that is due to at the time of gamete formation is after crossing over होती है. This crossing over that will also bring the variation in the living organism. Next, at the time of fertilization होती है fusion of male and female gamete cells. Male gamete cell is sperm and female gamete cell is egg. So when these two fuse, then due to this transunion of male and female gamete cells, variations or some new combinations of genes are formed which bring the variation or new character in next generation. So these variations which can be due to these regions, what is the use of these variations? These variations sometimes they make the organisms powerful for the better survival in the changed environment. We know that environment keep on changing. So in changed environment, those organisms which are able to adapt that will survive, and which are not able to adapt that changed environment, they will vanish out with time. So these variations before changing the environment, they bring pre-adaptations in the living organism or in the next generation which help them for surviving in the changed environment or when these conditions come. Now, modes of reproduction. Before this, I am giving some example of variation. You will see that number of organisms, they are living at a particular place and keep on increasing their population. When population expanded to the larger area, then the group of population, they are living at certain places or in a particular niche. So according to that niche, they are having their characteristics, their way of living or their survival. But as they change from one niche to another niche, then also the variation comes. आप भी देखिए आप यहाँ से कहीं उठ जाते हैं तो आप देखिए कि हमारे कस्टम्स भी चेंज हो जाते हैं, वे ऑफ लिविंग भी चेंज हो जाता है और सर्वाइवल का ढंग भी चेंज हो जाता है. That is also variation. Right? So, in the surrounding also, bacteria पहले क्या थे? They are all, they were all similar. But as the environment changed, so what happens? And suddenly the temperature, surrounding temperatures increases. Then what happens? हुआ क्या? कि जब temperature increase हुआ, तो most of the bacteria they started dying. बहुत सारे बैक्टीरिया जो है वो मर गए. अब कुछ बैक्टीरिया जो है स्टिल दे सर्वाइव, कुछ बैक्टीरिया अभी भी सर्वाइव कर रहे, तो इन बैक्टीरिया को हमने नाम दिया हीट रेजिस्टेंट बैक्टीरिया. और इन हीट रेजिस्टेंट बैक्टीरिया ने जब रिप्रोडक्शन की या जब एसेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन की, तो उन्होंने जो नेक्स्ट जनरेशन प्रोड्यूस की फ्रॉम हीट रेजिस्टेंट बैक्टीरिया, ओनली हीट रेजिस्टेंट बैक्टीरिया they are produced. And these heat resistant bacteria, they kept on increasing their number, and in this way the variety changed when variation came in the environment. Now modes of reproduction. A modes of reproduction kya hai? There are two modes of reproduction, asexual and sexual.
Fertilization, no fusion of gametes. And fourth characteristic, when they are
इवोल्यूशन। इवोल्यूशन के इनका फॉर्म प्ले नहीं होता। सो दीज आर द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ एसेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन। नाउ कम टू द सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन। सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इज द प्रोडक्ट रिप्रोडक्शन। सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन में क्या होता है? सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इज द रिप्रोडक्शन इन विच द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म दे रिप्रोड्यूस विद द हेल्प ऑफ मेल और मेल फीमेल पेरेंट सेल्स पेरेंट ऑर्गेनिज्म। इट मींस इट इज बाय पेरेंटल एंड रिक्वायर टू डिफरेंट पेरेंट। वन इज मेल एंड अदर इज फीमेल बाय पेरेंटल
again generation
vegetative propagation. इसको हम vegetative reproduction कहते हैं। तो फीजन में टू टाइप्स होती है, बाइंडिंग एंड मल्टी बाइंडिंग एंड मल्टीपल फीजन। बाइंडिंग दो में होता है, यूनिसेलर और मल्टी सेलर ऑर्गेनिज्म। Right?